We spent a lot of 2021 taking things apart, and we found a ton of interesting technology, some unexpected surprises, and even a couple of repairable devices. But unfortunately, most companies are trending toward the less repairable side of that scale. In fact, you might not be surprised to hear that over half the devices we tore down last year scored a 5 or below on our repairability scale. That said, last year was also a big year for Right to Repair, with several countries considering legislation and one country, France, actually passing legislation that requires manufacturers to include repair information and a repair score on certain products. To get 2022 started right, we're going to recap the best and worst devices that we found in 2021, and then tell you what we're looking forward to in 2022. Let's get the bad stuff out of the way first. If there's one category of devices that almost always ends up on our worst of list, it's earbuds. In fact, when the original AirPods were released, we were convinced that wireless earbuds could never be repairable. This year, Apple released a redesigned pair of AirPods, but unfortunately, not much has changed for their repairability. AirPods 3 are still tightly glued together, requiring destructive surgery to disassemble. The biggest change we found was the battery, which is now located in the bud rather than hidden away in the stem of the AirPod. The battery was no longer soldered in place and is actually much easier to disconnect thanks to a clever connector. It's a very interesting improvement, but it's ultimately not enough to save them from a 0 out of 10 repairability score because taking them apart still requires breaking them. But Apple wasn't the only manufacturer to fail the repairability test. London-based company Nothing released their inaugural product, the Nothing Ear Ones, this year, and unfortunately, they couldn't score above a 1 on our repairability scale. Our teardown revealed buds that were not only complicated to disassemble, but like the AirPods, their repairability is hampered by design choices that make reassembly almost impossible. These low earbud scores might make you think that all wireless earbuds just aren't meant to be repaired, and I could see why you'd think that. But we've actually seen some manufacturers make choices in this space that allow for things like replaceable batteries and easy-ish disassembly. If you're curious, make sure to check out our Galaxy Buds teardowns to see what I'm talking about. The final bad device of 2021 is not an earbud, though I think it might actually be thinner than an earbud. It's the M1 Silicon iMac. After you cut through the adhesive on that super expensive screen to get inside, there's no socketed storage or memory to swap for an upgrade, but there are thankfully at least a couple of replaceable parts. Hopefully, all you ever need to replace in this desktop computer are speakers and ports. The iMac earned a measly 2 out of 10 on our repairability scale. Now on to the good. Just in the last few months, we saw two products that prove it's possible to make a modern, compelling device with sustainability and repairability in mind. First up, the awesome Framework laptop. This was pretty much our dream laptop. It's easy enough for a beginner to put together and take apart, and it's made by a company committed to supplying spare parts and repair information directly to consumers. It even has really cool plug-and-play modular ports. The only thing I'd change is the addition of a dedicated GPU, which hopefully will come soon. The Framework laptop earned a 10 out of 10 on our repairability scale. That wasn't the only 10 out of 10 we gave this year, though. We were able to get our hands on a Fairphone 4 and take that apart. With an opening procedure that only requires your fingers, a battery that pops right out, the ability to expand storage with a microSD card, and a simple modular design, the Fairphone 4 also easily earned a 10 out of 10 on our repairability scale. Moving on to this new year, we have the same hopes. We want everyone to be able to repair everything, and it should be an interesting year on that front. Here are a few things that have our attention looking forward to 2022. Toward the end of last year, Apple announced a new repair program aimed at DIYers. To get the full scoop, you can watch this conversation we had with our CEO, Kyle Weens. That program is supposed to start early this year, giving users access to the iPhone 12 and iPhone 13 parts, guides, and tools, with M1 Max support coming shortly after that. Apple was incredibly vague on the details of how most of this works, so we are very interested to see how they're going to pull this off and whether it will actually be a viable DIY repair option for most people. I'm curious to see whether this will influence the design of the iPhone 14 and the new MacBook Air. Speaking of Apple, 2021 also gave us a totally redesigned MacBook Pro that was considerably more repair friendly. With a new iMac Pro potentially coming this year, it'll be interesting to see whether that gets a repairability bump and maybe some modularity, making it more like the super repair-friendly Mac Pro and less like the M1 iMac on our worst of list. And as always, I'm hopeful that this will be the year that Apple thinks about iPad repair, but I know that's a lost cause. Moving away from Apple, there's a new smart device standard coming in 2022 that has the potential to finally eliminate all the headache that comes with setting up fancy smart light bulbs. It's called Matter, and though it probably won't be ready until late this year, I'm guessing it's going to mean another big wave of smart home devices. We've taken apart some virtual assistants with varying degrees of ease, and our friends at Instrumental have actually done a few smart home device teardowns as well. Thankfully, most smart home devices don't have batteries, which means the only reason you really need to take them apart is for less common electronics failure and in the event of an unfortunate kitchen spill. The really big bummer about smart home tech is that once it's not supported by software, it often just becomes useless. Looking at you, smart speakers without audio inputs. For a sneak peek at some of this year's worst devices, you can check out repair.org's Worst of CES show, where they name and shame some of the worst products and product ideas from CES 2022. And be sure to let us know if there's anything cool or interesting that you want us to look at from CES in the next few months. We're watching closely, but there's a lot to miss.